What's up, everybody? It's your boy George, back at it again with another video. Today we're here at the University of Texas, El Paso, home to the UTEP Miners. Tonight, the men's basketball team will be taking on Sam Houston in what is expected to be a thriller. But today's video is a special video because we'll be honoring the life and career of not only an El Paso legend, but a college basketball legend as well, the Bear, Coach Don Haskins. The university will be celebrating Coach Haskins with a statue in front of the arena named after him, forever immortalizing his legacy here in El Paso. It's an honor to be able to feature Coach Haskins and the University of Texas, El Paso, on my channel. You're watching EP Originals. What's up, guys? It's your boy George. I'm back at it again. Today we are here in the west side of El Paso, Texas. It's a beautiful day, so just decided to come out here and enjoy it. It was my day off, but in a couple of days we're going to be going to a UTEP Miners basketball game. They're going to be playing against Sam Houston here in El Paso at the Don Haskins Center. We're going to go get some footage because they're going to give Don Haskins a statue in front of the arena that's named after him. So Don Haskins, it's a legend, probably one of the biggest legends to come out of El Paso. His career and the story of the 1966 Texas Western team was documented in the movie Glory Road that Disney made a couple years ago, or it came out in 2006. So about like 17, 18 years ago. That movie went on to be a hit, you know what I'm saying, and a classic and one of my favorite movies. So we're gonna go to the game. The game's in a couple of days, but right now we're just coming to get some footage of the actual school, the college. I've never really been to UTEP, even though, you know, I've been here my whole life and everything. So hopefully I could just blend in on the campus and everything and nobody trips out on me or nothing. So we out here. guys, so the day is here, MOT. It's a reveal day, you know what I'm saying? Such an honor to be here, like I said, to be able to showcase Coach Haskins on my channel. He did so much for our community. Ever since the day that he arrived here in 1961, he stayed here, he called El Paso his home, and any time he could, he gave back to our community, to our people, and it's just beautiful that they're finally able to celebrate him and forever immortalize him in front of the place that he helped build, the house that he helped build and everything. Forever he will be immortalized in front of it, and for the public to come and see too, you know. So an El Paso legend, a college basketball legend, and just overall a great man. And I'm really excited to be able to show the statue. And if you're watching this video and haven't been able to come and see it for yourself, I really recommend that you guys do. So we got about 30 more minutes before they start their little pep rally and everything. Looks like they're gonna give a speech, and I'm excited, so stay tuned.
But this is an even bigger celebration of UTEP basketball for this great community. We are also honoring the 40th year reunion and anniversary of the 1983-84 UTEP basketball team, a very special group. That team went on to win 27 games. They went on to participate in the NC2A basketball tournament. They won the Western Athletic Conference championship. That was the second straight of five consecutive Western Athletic Conference championship teams here at UTEP. And it was also the very first of seven consecutive NC2A tournament teams here at UTEP. Seven in a row. Conceptualize that, will you? That year, for those of you that are old enough to remember, this group won all 21 of their games played behind me in the Don Haskins Center, unbeaten. I think we had 11 or 12 sellouts that year. It was just an incredible, incredible season. And all weekend long, we have been celebrating the 40th reunion and the 40th anniversary of that great achievement. I'm going to be rotating not only the 83-84 guys, but all of the players that returned along with you to celebrate the unveiling of the Don Haskins statue. And we're going to hear from each and every one of them as to their memories of Coach Haskins and what it meant to play for the great Hall of Fame head coach here at the University of Texas at El Paso. I want to thank Dan and Joanne Longoria. Dan, are you here? I'm sure you're here. Dan and Joanne Longoria are the ones, and they have done so many wonderful things for this community, and they are the ones that paid for this statue to be sculpted and made and transported to El Paso and now installed here on the East Plaza of the Don Haskins Center. Brian Hanlon, are you here? Brian is actually the sculptor of the Don Haskins statue. He has done quite a few statues of those that are enshrined in the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame, Coach Haskins being the latest. And we want to thank Brian Hanlon for putting together this great rendition of Coach Haskins that we're going to unveil in just a few moments. Let's unveil the statue. I want to invite all the UTEP players, coaches, and trainers up to join me in front of the statue as we unveil Coach Haskins. All right, on the count of three, I want you guys to yank the drape and unveil Brian Hanlon's rendition of our Hall of Fame head coach, Don Haskins. Three, two, one, unveil. Well, somebody's got to yank it. Both sides. Julius, step up. Steve, go ahead. Steve, Cheese, go ahead. Once again, we count it down. Take two. In three, two, one.
So what's up, guys? It's halftime right now. The Miners are down by 4, but it's been a good game so far. They just, you know, some turnovers, you know what I'm saying? Sam Houston's defense is pretty good, but, you know, we still got a chance. So far, it's been a great game. They just finished celebrating the 1983-84 Miners team, and it's a great turnout, to be honest. It's a really great turnout, and just happy that the city is here showing love, and hopefully we can start filling this stadium up more. So.
Checking in at game number 5, Marcus Boyka.
Good for the sensor. I learned to sing like slam dunks.
Let's end the ball game. The final score of the Bearcats, 65 and the Miners, 54. And our fans, our men's basketball team returns to the non-Haskins Center for Senior Day on Thursday, March 7th at 7 p.m. as they take on FIU.
So that's the end of the video, guys. Thanks for watching. Like I said, it was an honor to feature Don Haskins here on EP Originals. The Bear was the coach at UTEP for 38 years, ranking up 719 wins, 14 NCAA tournament appearances, and topping it all off in the 1966 National Championship game, dethroning the University of Kentucky Wildcats, who were at that time were coached by Adolph Ruff, one of the greatest college basketball coaches that there was. Don Haskins at that time wasn't trying to make a social statement or anything. He just wanted to start his best players that he felt that were gonna give him the best chance at winning that game. And they just happened to be all of his black players. After that game, Coach Haskins went on record saying that sometimes he wished that they would have came in second place because of all the backlash that he got, the negative comments, and even receiving death threats in the mail to his house, his family, and everything like that. And it just sucks because Coach Haskins, like he said, he wasn't trying to make a social justice statement or anything like that. He just wanted to win college basketball games and give young men the opportunity to go out there and be able to play the game that they love. People who were dedicated to the game and who were willing to sacrifice, no matter what color, race, size that they were, if they were willing to be dedicated to the game of basketball, Coach Haskins was going to give them that opportunity. And he did that for over 38 years, especially here in my city, in my community of El Paso, Texas. So how could I have a show called EP Originals without featuring one of the men who just, you know, was able to put and help put El Paso on the national spotlight? Much love to Don Haskins. When I heard that they were gonna honor him with a statue in front of his arena, I definitely made sure that I had to be there to be able to record and get at least some footage to be able to feature it here on the channel. And unfortunately, he passed away in 2008. And at that time, you know, I was a little boy and everything, but the way that I learned about Coach Haskins was through the movie Glory Road that Disney had made around 2006, about the story about, you know, Texas Western, what they were called at the time, winning the championship and going, you know, through all of these odds and everything like that. And it was just really amazing. For the game, we went to the game against Sam Houston too, and I'm sorry I didn't really get a lot of footage. I thought I did, but unfortunately some of it deleted, especially the halftime footage, because they honored one of the greatest teams that UTEP had, the 1983-84 UTEP Miners team, which ended up going undefeated that year and here in El Paso. So thanks to everybody who watched this video and everybody who subscribed to the channel. It really does mean a lot to me. Your support, you don't know how much that helps, especially sharing the videos and everything like that on YouTube. That really does mean a lot. So thank you guys. I really hope you guys appreciate this video and enjoyed it, because I really had fun making it and trying to celebrate and honor an El Paso legend in the best way that I could. You know what I'm saying? So much love to everybody. We out here. Make sure you guys are doing more of what you love to do, and go Miners. Till next episode. Peace.
This is for the University of Texas at El Paso, our president, and the people of El Paso. Thank you very much.